Hello everyone, I welcome you all in the new semester and in my class of CIS 2168, that is Data Driven Design. I am Dr. Hari Mohan Pandey, the module leader for this module. My contact details are given here. You can see my contact details are given here. I have given my contact details here so that you can easily reach to me for any queries. This is the very first session of CIS 2168 Data Driven Design. Therefore, I will start this session by giving a detailed overview of this module. As far as overview of this module is concerned, I have classified the overview into three main categories. First, I will be giving an introduction about the module where the key focus will be on module handbook and blackboard, on timetable and on the assessment. Secondly, I will be discussing the topics which we will learn throughout the semester, that is in the next 12 weeks. And finally, I will be touching upon the tutorials that have been developed to give a practical taste of the theoretical topics. A teaching portal has been created for the for tutorial task. The online teaching portal will help you for self-learning. In order to access the online teaching portal, you can use the URL which is given over here. As far as the timetable for this module is concerned, there will be 3-hour session each week, where 1 hour is for pre-recorded video lectures and the remaining 2 hour will be for tutorial activities. As far as tutorial session is concerned, there will be 2 hour face-to-face contact session, and it is highly recommended that you discuss your doubts during the tutorial session. The classes will be organized on Thursday between 12 to 2 p.m. and the room number for this class is THF04. Now, the next we will discuss how the module will be supported. The module will be supported through the Blackboard, that is all the learning materials will be available on the Blackboard. So you can use the Blackboard to access the learning material. If you have any question, do not stay silent. You can discuss your doubts during the tutorial session. You can write me email. My email ID is given here. There will be a drop-in session or office hours. And all the office hours and drop-in session will be supported through Microsoft Teams or Skype for Business. A timetable will be provided on the Blackboard for the office hours and for the drop-in session. So you can use, I will be available online during that time. So you can ping me, you can discuss your doubts during those sessions. Now, this is the screenshot of the Blackboard. I have given this screenshot to make you understand how we will use the Blackboard for accessing the learning materials. So here you can see the general information about the module, such as Blackboard, timetable, announcement, tutor details, etc., can be found under the area Home Hub, which is given here. Weekly teaching materials such as lecture slides, videos, tutorials can be found under Learning area. Coursework specification like coursework coursework document, about drop-in box, deadlines for the coursework submission, receipt, etc. comes under the assessment area of the blackboard. Now, we will discuss briefly about what is data-driven design and why it is important. So this slide will introduce you what is data-driven design. Data-driven design can be defined as design that is backed by the data that helps the user to understand targeted audience. So what we are intended in, we are intended in to create a design which is supported by data which will come from the user to understand what target audience wants. It helps to understand the work is on the right track or not. So you can use the data to understand you are going in a right direction, right track, you are on right track or not. It reveals user pain point and opportunities while showing new trends. So the data which we will use will help us to understand the pattern so that you can understand you can understand the new trends in the business. It helps in improving your design. So you can use the target targeted audience feedback as a data to improve your design by adding new objectives. Basically, data-driven design models include the use of data mining and machine learning and statistics. So we will use some statistics, we will use some machine learning techniques, we will use data mining techniques to extract the relevant information and we will use those information to frame the objectives for better design. In addition to this, data-driven design models are used in engineering, science and business with the predictive goal. So we will use the data to frame new objectives for prediction, what will happen in the near future. And we can use the data for forecasting the value of a variable and we will use the data to understand and discover new patterns in the available data. Now in the next slide, I have given why there is a need of data-driven design. So here you can see there are several reasons of using data-driven design, and I have highlighted three key reasons. The first reason is the information gathered from the user can help to identify potential weakness. So we can collect feedback from the user, and that data will be used to identify the weakness in the existing website or in the weakness in the business. Data collected from the user will help in providing a starting point for further investigation. So the data which will collect from the user will provide us the weaknesses, and the same data can be a starting point for further discussion and for further investigation and to improve the design and to improve the business goals. So overall, data-driven design can help in improving product performance. So I have listed here some three key reasons, and there are many other reasons given for data-driven design. Now, data-driven design has wide range of applications. It helps user to search, explore, and draw constructive conclusion based on the data in hand. In addition to this, it helps business leader to identify pattern between operational and business activities. Pattern identification is very effective in business development as it improves emerging trends. It provides emerging trends based on the data. So a business leader can use the pattern of the pattern which will come from the data for the improvement of the business. The goal of this module is given in the next slide. So here you can see the goal of the module is divided into two categories. First one is theoretical goal and practical goal. So as far as theoretical goal is concerned, this module covers statistical concepts, basics of natural language processing, and machine learning methods. In practical session, you will work on large volume of real world data, and you will perform various activities on the data, such as log analysis, query analysis, temporal analysis, statistics on the data in hand, and data visualization. Now in the next slide, I have given what will be covered in week wise manner. So you can see here, in the first week, I will be covering Python programming. Then so in the second week, page hit analysis. Week number third is dedicated for temporal analysis. Week four is for query analysis. In week five, you will learn some statistics. Week five and six is for basic statistics and statistical significance. In week seven, you will work on log filtering. Week eight is for session tracking. Week nine, path analysis. Week 10 is for, in week 10, you will learn machine learning methods. Week number 11 is for flow design, and week number 12, coursework 2 submission. So if you have any doubt in coursework 2, you can discuss and you can submit your coursework 2. I will be giving giving a brief idea about coursework 2 in this session, and again in week number 5 and week number 9, so that you can and during these two sessions, that is week number 5 and week number 9, I will spend around half an hour or 1 hour as per the demand of the student for coursework 2. The structure of this session, is like, you can see three blocks are given here. First one is for feedback, second one is for the lecture, and third one is for the tutorial and seminar session. Every week, approximately half an hour will be devoted for the feedback on the weekly task. The feedback will help you to progress in a fruitful manner throughout the semester. As far as the lecture is concerned, as I mentioned earlier, 1 hour pre-recorded video lecture will be shared on the Blackboard to cover theoretical concepts and theoretical concepts, that is theories, ideas, and concepts. And 2 hour face-to-face session will be organized for the tutorial, and it will and in this tutorial session, you will work on practical problems on your own. I will be available during this tutorial session to supervise and to help you if you will get stuck at any point when you will implement your code. Then I will be there to help you. And at the end of each week tutorial, you will be asked to work on portfolio task. So at the end of each week tutorial, you will work on a task, and the task will consist of five questions. Now the next slide is for the assessment. As far as the assessment is concerned, you can see there will be two coursework, coursework 1 and coursework 2. The first assessment is referred as coursework 1, and the weightage for coursework 1 is 20%. Coursework 1 is portfolio based weekly task which you will complete individually. So it will be individual coursework. A program is created for automatically checking and marking your submission. So when you will submit your task, I will use a program for auto marking. So your submission will be auto marked and you will be provided marks and feedback for the submission. On the other hand, coursework 2 will be application oriented assessment where you will be asked to create a build and prepare a report. So in coursework 2, the weightage is 80%. You will create a build, you will develop an application and a report. And coursework 2 is a teamwork based assessment, and here the weightage is 80%. More detail about the coursework 1 and coursework 2 is given in the coming slides. So the next slide is for the coursework 1. As I mentioned in the previous slide, the weightage for coursework 1 is 20%. In coursework 1, learning outcome 1 will be assessed, and the task, weekly task, will be provided, and there will be total 10 tasks you will complete, and each task will consist of 5 questions. So each task includes 5 questions to complete, and you will complete and submit your coursework individually to showcase your skills that you have learned throughout the semester. Now for the submission of the coursework, so you can see this table is given, handout date and deadline is given here in column number 1, column number 2 and column number 3. Column number 1 is the name of the task. So task 1, you can see, will be issued in week number 2, and the deadline for the submission for task 1 is week number 3. Similarly, task 2, week number 3, the issue date is week 3, submission date is week 4. Similarly for rest of the task. Now for the submission of the task, all the submission will be on the blackboard. You will you can access the blackboard, and you can find drop box for the submission of the task. For any query related to coursework 1, or for if you are doing your task and you have any difficulty in completing, then you can write me email, and be specific while writing the email. You need to put the subject line course CIS 1, CIS 2168 coursework 1 question, the deadline for the submission, and handing date and submission deadline. You can see on the blackboard. I have clearly specified the black deadlines for the submission of each task on the blackboard. Now the next slide is for grading and marking. So this table is given to make you understand the assessment criteria and grading scheme. So you can see the marking range is given for different grades: fail, narrow fail, pass, good, very good, excellent, and outstanding. And this is the criteria. So these this row shows the criteria for getting these grades and marks. And as I already mentioned, learning outcome 1 will be assessed in coursework 1. Now coming to coursework 2, the weightage is 80%. So the lion's share is given for of the assessment is given for coursework 2. For the deadline, dates and time, you need to check the blackboard assessment area, And in coursework 2, learning outcome 2 and learning outcome 3 will be assessed. The task, this will be coursework 2 will be teamwork based coursework, and in this the task is given here. So you have been asked to work on a large volume of data, and you need to analyze the data. You can access the log file through a shared cloud area. The name of the file is this, and the team member will work on the analysis of the log which will be shared to you. So more detail about the coursework is given in the next slide. So what is expected from the coursework 2? So as I said, you can access the log file from the shared cloud area, and this file you will use to perform several tasks. So first task is filtering the log. Then there will be four student this coursework 2 is a teamwork based assessment, and each member of the team will work on some analysis, like I have mentioned here: page analysis, temporal analysis, query analysis, and session analysis. So for example, there are four students. So student one is doing page analysis, student two is doing temporal analysis, student three is doing query analysis, student four is performing session analysis. Then you need to prepare a report for different analysis, and you need to present the conclusion based on your observations, based on your finding, and in addition to conclusion, you need to provide the test report and recommendations. So how you will start working on coursework 2? So I have given in this slide, I have given an idea about how you can start the initial planning for doing the coursework. So first of all, what you have to do, you will be provided the coursework. So coursework is assigned to you. And if you have any doubts, so you need to clarify your doubts with your tutor or with your team members. Then you need to structure your team. You need to identify the student who will participate in the teamwork. And then you can make initial planning. So planning is required for individual to share the work. So how you will, individual student will work on any specific topic, and at the end, how he or she will share the work. Then apply appropriate technique to complete the analysis, and then present the conclusion. What will be assessed for the coursework? So your report will be assessed. You will be assessed individually for the main analysis. So suppose any student is working on page hit analysis, so student performance will be assessed for the page analysis and then for the overall report. And so you will be assessed individually and then all together in a group. So here I have given the assessment criteria for the coursework 2. So you can see the assessment criteria is based on four key factors. So your assessment will be done based on analysis quality, analysis and report coverage, readability of the report, and referencing. So you need to provide the proper referencing in order to complete your report and to back up your report. Now, guideline for the submission of coursework 2. So here you can see an example is given for naming the report. So you can use last name, your last name, first initial, student name, and the coursework. Like here I have given last name is Pandey, initial is Hari, that is H. I have taken some student number and then coursework. If you have any doubt in coursework 2, then you can write the email with the subject line CIS2168 coursework 2 questions. Here I have given some important point for the submission and preparation of the report. So front page of the report must show the name and enrollment number of each student, that is the team members. You need to include a table in the report to show the contribution of each member. So you need to prepare a table with 3 column or 4 column, and each row will specify the contribution of the individual student. The last point says that though it is the group work, but each team member will be asked to submit the report. So what, suppose 4 students are working for coursework 2, then all 4 students need to submit the report on the blackboard so that I can see and I can mark your report. This table presents the marking criteria for coursework 2. So here you can see different factors are given for marking the submission. So you can see the first column is for initial planning, and the 30% weightage is given for the initial planning. For the log filtering, 20% weightage is given. For analysis quality, 25% weightage is given. For documentation, 15% weightage is given. And for testing document, 10% weightage is given. And here the first column presents the range and grade for the coursework 2. Now this slide presents the contact and support for this module. So if you have any question, then you can ask during the seminar session. You can write me email. The response I will generally give, I will try my best to respond you immediately, but you need to keep in mind that response usually takes 24 to 48 hours. Office hours and drop-in sessions are given for this module, and I will be available online during the office hours. So you can see the office hours is on Tuesday and Wednesday. So on Tuesday, the timing is 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. and on Wednesday, it is 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. And all the for office hours, you have to use Microsoft Teams or Skype for Business. You can make appointment if you want to discuss your doubt other than office hours or other than tutorial and seminar session. Since you are going to use Microsoft Teams and Skype for Business, so you have to have, you need to ensure that you have working camera and microphone to discuss your doubt online. That's all from my side. Thank you very much and happy learning.